morning everyone. So again we are here with your commerce class. So I think all of you are prepared now to listen more about functional structural organization. You have listened to the video yesterday and I hope the meaning of functional structure is clear now. So proceeding with the same topic today, the number of specialists involved in functional foremanship, a very important aspect when we draw a functional structure, the need of specialists, their types, merits and demerits of this structure along with its suitability, and also we have to relate the line organization with functional organization. Before starting today's topic, let us first revise the learning objectives of this chapter. First of all, first objective is aids to management. Organizing facilitates growth and creativity. Organizing ensures optimum use of resources. Organizing helps in establishing relationship among individual groups. Organizing clusters all jobs into units. It helps in coordinating the activities of the different departments. Organizing help in performing an analysis about the work, identifying the work, and moreover, it also helps in grouping of activities necessary for attaining objectives. So while going through the chapter, we will be able to learn these objectives. And as we know, organizing helps in getting results. So while making a mind map of the chapter, so we have so far covered organizing, its meaning and importance, the organizing process, line organization, formal and informal organization, and yesterday we had started with functional organization, and moreover we will also cover line and staff organization, divisional structure, centralization, decentralization, delegation in this week. Okay, tell me, how many of you have a Airtel connection? Me having one, and how many of you are having? So I suppose that Airtel is the best prepaid and postpaid both mobile network connection these days. It is giving very best of its services and it's a leading telecommunication company in India. Don't be surprised, but this company is following a functional structural organization as it follows the same structure, because this structure helps the company to run its working very smoothly. So while looking at the functional structure of Airtel company, first of all, there is chairman and managing director named as Sunil Bharti Mittal. He is the chairman as well as MD of the company. He has two CEOs, one India and South Asia. The person Sanjay Kapoor, he is covering India and South Asia part. International and JMD is covered by Manoj Kohli. So chairman has mainly divided his work with two specialists, that is Sanjay Kapoor and Manoj Kohli. And further, more staff specialists are added in their group. So first of all, they have a president of B2C, that is K. Srinivas. Now all of you have learned about B2C in plus one, that is business to commerce. Right? From business, how can we provide aids to the public? Commerce is exchange of goods and services with the help of aids to commerce. I think all of you must remember what are the different aids to commerce: transport, warehousing, banking, insurance, finance. These are aids to commerce which helps in smooth flow of goods and services. Other than that, we also have operations director west and national distribution. Now see, under this president there are two operational staff specialists. One is operating at west and national distribution, another is operating at south and Sri Lanka. Raghunath Mansahai is for west part and Visit Taneja is covering south and Sri Lanka part. Other than that, now this CEO has one president for B2C, that is business to commerce, ultimately reaching the public. Another president is Duke Kelton, who is B2B. B2B is business to business. That is business of Airtel as a telecommunication company with other companies. Like suppose if that company wants to give an offer in a collaboration with some other IT companies, or they are taking softwares, they are taking the implementation ideas of other executives of the same telecommunication line, then it is B2B commerce. Then this president has another director which is for Northeast part operations in Bangladesh also, and his name is Ajay Puri. After that, there is a team of executive directors. First executive director is human resource director, that is dealing with all the employees and staff present in the company. Krish Shankar. Another executive director is supply chain, that is how this company is making its network worldwide famous, and why do people have more reliance on this company for buying their networks and for proceeding with them. Next is their next director for services group. Now services are the different packages which they offer to the customers, different offers which they give while assessing a network of Airtel. That is Mr. Jagbir Singh. Then this executive director also have one more officer, that is Chief Finance Officer CFO Nilanjan Roy. Here comes executive directors, then network directors, and now the other directors relating to other functions. One is legal and regulatory, that is Jyoti Pawar. For main the IT director, they have Amrita Gangotra. So now this is an example of a telecommunication company. You can see the example. We are talking about functional organizational structure in which hierarchy is to follow the command from top to bottom, but at every step the immediate boss changes. In this example, you can see for CEO's immediate boss is chairman, and for others the immediate boss are presidents, executive directors, the legal department heads. So directors and their operations depend upon the type of department they are handling. Similarly, when we talk about functional organization, the business expands, large scale production take place, and which need the use of such experts in the different fields to have more planning of work and to compete with the strategies of other competitors. So from this example, we can say that in a functional organizational structure, organizations' reporting relationships are grouped. They are based on speciality or functional areas. Legal section, B2B, B2C, HR, public relation, IT sector. So according to the different functional areas, the experts are appointed. For example, there might be separate departments for marketing, accounting and engineer. All these departments are needed in an organization. We need marketing, we need accounting, we need engineering in a manufacturing company, but they need special effort, the experts which can have more command over their actions to be done by the workers. Generally, all the functional heads will report directly to the company president or CEO. Now, every functional head, all directors have to report to the CEO of the company, and then CEO further reported back to the chairman or MD of a company. A functional structure is the one that divides the major functions of a firm into different groups. For example, information technology department, finance department, marketing department, production department. So functional structure is a structure in which firm has divided their activities into major functions, into different groups, and every group is provided with a head to manage all the activities in a proper manner. While going through the topic of functional organization, you will come across terms and listen properly so that you are able to answer these key terms of your own. So, functional organization structure depends upon the size of the business. As business expands and large scale production take place, so there arise the need of experts. A department is added, a person is required to handle it. More the number of departments, more the number of experts. Let us start with the concept of functional foremanship. This is another name of functional organization structure as suggested by Taylor. So Taylor has suggested the functional foremanship concept to be followed in those organizations, those who have a vast area of fields and activities to be performed in their concerns. So we have two type of specialist under functional foremanship. First is office specialist, another is shop specialist. Under office specialist, we have route clerk, instruction card clerk, time and cost clerk, and a disciplinarian. Under shop specialist, we have gang boss, speed boss, repair boss, and inspector. First of all, we have office specialists. The experts who design, schedule, record, and plan work. The one who are at the authority to design activities, to schedule those activities, record and planning of work. Then under office specialist, our first type was route clerk. So who is a route clerk? Who plan the route from which work will pass from machine to machine, finished goods are ready in time. So route clerk is a person who is planning the way by which the product in its raw form pass from machine 1 to machine 2 and so on until then it is converted into a finished good. So that he is known as a route clerk, as he sets the path of passage of stock. Next is instruction card clerk. instruction card clerk record instructions for doing every piece of work. Exact method of doing the work is recorded. He actually observed different persons performing the same activity in a department. For example, in a production department, the production is taking place and 8 workers are working on 2 machines. He is noticing each and every worker. He is counting their number of motions. He is counting the speed at which they are working. Then he decides the best one, record that person's each and every activity. Then he will make it in the form of an instruction card to be followed by everyone as it becomes a standard method of following the same. Then he declared that method as an exact method of performing an activity. After this, we have time and cost clerk. Time and cost clerk is an expert who lays down the standard time for completing a particular work. He has decided in what time a work should be completed. Suppose in the morning, the workers have got a target to produce 500 tons in 1 week, and then he decides that how much work will be done by one worker in a single day. He supplies every information that the worker required. He helps them, he provides them with requisite material he wants, with information he wants, and he records the time taken for completing one record, that how much time the laborer take for completing of one unit. Then also the time part which he concluded, the time part which he records will help him in calculating the cost of various jobs. That's why he is known as time and cost clerk, because he manages time, he notices time, he sets a standard time and count the cost also. Thus, the cost which is involved in a particular activity helps in deriving out the benefits which the firm can have if they minimize it in a minute form. Now, after route clerk, instruction clerk, time and cost clerk, next is disciplinarian. So, who is a disciplinarian? One who ensures the implementation of all rules and regulations. He tries to make and maintain proper discipline at work. That work is starting in proper time. It is going through without any interruptions, and now it is done in proper sequence and the job is completed so as the job is to be confined in the same way as others have to perform it. So these were office specialists. As we were discussing about the one who designed the activity, the plan the activity, and we have 4 types of office specialists: route clerk, instruction clerk, time and cost clerk, and disciplinarian. After that, next is shop specialist. Shop specialization means the persons, the experts who guide and supervise the work in the factory. They are at the lower level of management. They are one who gives direction and supervise the work in the factory. First of all, while talking about shop specialist, the first shop specialist in a company is a gang boss. He arranges tools and machines at work. He is responsible for arranging all the tools and equipments. Next, he ensures adequate work for the workers and sees that necessary tools are available to the workers. First thing, he makes sure that the workers who are doing work, they have all equipments with them to complete the job. Second thing, he makes sure that all the work will be done by the workers and see that every required material is available with them at at appropriate time. Also, the gang boss tries every work to be completed at the earliest. He makes all possible efforts. He convinces workers. He somehow pressurizes them to complete the work on or before time so that there is no delay in further processes in the organization. Next, after the gang boss, next is speed boss. So as the name suggests, speed boss is one who checks the flow of activities, that how fast a particular activity is going in the organization. So a speed boss check at which the work goes on to ensure work is completed at right time. He is checking the speed of the worker, the speed at which the worker is performing an activity. He is performing it in right time or not, and also he guides the workers in keeping proper pace of work. After speed boss, next is repair boss. Gang boss see availability of machines and tools. Speed boss checks the completion of work at right time. Now repair boss is one, the expert who ensures that machines and tools are maintained in proper condition, that there is no harm while doing activity and machines are in their proper condition. Workers clean their machines properly and maintain them with standard care. So he is the one who has to look after all the machines. Next type of shop specialist is an inspector. He is the one who ensures work is done according to the prescribed standards and qualities, that he has to inspect all the work, that whether the work is going according to the standard and as per quality. Workers also maintain proper workmanship of the goods manufactured. They maintain proper workmanship, that is, they are justifying the work for the ultimate consumer. So when we talk about our office and staff specialist, so if we go through a network, first of all we have board of directors, then we have chief executive, then works manager, then the production manager. There is a line of authority which is flowing from top level to the lower levels. And then under the production manager, we have different type of staff specialists, the experts who are there to guide and help the persons working in the organization. They are route clerk, instruction clerk, time clerk, disciplinarian, gang boss, repair boss, speed boss, inspector. The first four clerks who are working under the office specialist, who are in the job of planning and implementation, they are called office specialist. And those who are directly involved with the production and dealing with machines, they are called shop specialist. And the one who plays a very important role in making these office and shop specialists as the workers. Their workers are the one who help them to get their work done at right time. They listen to them. They work under their leadership. Bosses guide, supervise, and workers follow them. So employees in an area need to report to all the directors. For example, an employee from a finance department may be called upon by HR manager to handle a matter related to this area. Same and so forth may be done by other departmental managers. This is not a hard and fast rule that if you are belonging to finance department, you are only accountable to the finance manager. Any other manager at the same level can call any person from other departments to handle the matters related to their own problems. So this avoids centralization and excessive specialization in tasks in your areas. So there is division of work, no burden on the executives, and moreover, they are specialized in the activity but not over specialized, excessively specialized. Everything will depend on the relationship between the managers at different departments and their appropriate use of IT technology, the communication technology which is prevalent with them within the organization. For example, manufacturing industries, hotels, medium-sized car repair shops, medical clinics, other types of business where informal structure allows functional control over employees without generating conflict between managers. So, where we can see the functional structure operating within our society, in all the manufacturing enterprises, in hotels, medium-sized enterprises, car repair shops, medical clinics, and other business where informal structure plays an important role, where there is large scale of operations, in that case, we can control conflicts, we can control the employees with the help of functional foremanship. So by reading the functional organizational structure, what merits we can derive out of our examples? First is specialization. The functional structure provides benefits of specialization because every member, every manager is an expert in his field, and the benefit he can give to all the staff members present under him. As a result, the resources are fully utilized and there is efficiency in their operations. Next is economy. In functional organization structure, maximum production takes place. Focus is on maximum production, and therefore cost is reduced because there is no duplicity of efforts. Other is better control. One man control is there and the degree of centralization is reduced. In this case, there is joint supervision at work which helps to achieve effective control. Staffing. So, staffing, a word is there which is a very new word for commerce students. Staffing means putting the right person at right place at right time. Staffing is one of the benefit of functional organization. It is a component of functional organization because you are placing right expert under the right head in your organization, and in this way it becomes easier for a functional manager to have experts in one particular function. Moreover, functional organization helps in reducing the burden of executives because every departmental head looks after one function, so his burden and his key processes are reduced. And in this way, the merits of functional organization are more advantageous as compared to line organization. Next, we have demerits of functional organization. Like every organization has some pros and cons, similar with that, the functional organization also suffers from some limitations. Somehow, functional organization has a narrow scope. Because departments focus on working of their own departments only, but they are not working for the organization as a whole. Sometimes, achieving of organizational goals become difficult. For example, if in production department, their goal is to achieve high quality product, this will increase price, and the target group, that is the production department, will focus only on production part. But sales and profit department will have adverse effect of this policy on their roles. Next is, functional organization creates difficulty in fixing responsibility. In this organization, too much stress is focused on relationships, that there should be a good relationship between the staff and the supervisors and the workers. So sometimes confusion and overlapping of authority is there, because every time fixing responsibility is not that easy, and it is also difficult to hold a particular department. But if there is any irregularity, if a department is not working properly, it will affect the other departments also. Next is conflicts. Departments must perform in a smooth manner. Managers try to build functional areas in which there should be no conflict, there should be no rivalry between the departments. Somehow, one manager may be jealous or feel inferior or may feel prerogative to other departments, and therefore they will strive hard to promote their own importance. Similarly, experts with equal ranks have clashes. Their ego clashes must be there. Next is delayed decisions. So when organization grows, coordination between different departments become difficult. So long one department will give the desired result, other departments have to wait. Unless the all departments does not give proper results, the top level management cannot make any decision regarding the growth, survival and continuity of the business. This functional organizational structure seems very expensive, as the number of department keeps on increases with employing more and more staff experts, supervisors and workers to regulate the working. So we can conclude now that where is functional organizational suitable? Functional structure is present where organizational size is large, they have more number of activities to perform, and they want their every job to be highly specialized and important. Functional structure is suitable for small firms also, those who are having a single product but a large number of related products. For example, Sleepwell. You all must have listened about it. Sleepwell mattresses. So they don't only produce one kind of mattress. It's a small, medium-sized firm producing different product lines. Products are related. Mattresses, foam products, sofa products, then other cushion forms. So their product are related to each other, and they are following functional organizational structure. So can we recall the line organization? Can you establish any relationship between the line and functional organizational structure? So through a network, we can establish a relationship between line and functional structure. See here, there is the authority, managing director, say of Sleepwell mattresses. They have four departments: marketing manager, manager finance and administration, personal manager, production manager. Now, the straight lines are showing us the line authority, the flow of authority from managing director to different departments, from different departments to their deputy departments, and then to the workers. Like from marketing manager to showroom manager, then to workers, from finance and department to office manager, from production manager to foreman to further workers. But all these departments are interlinked with each other, because every functional department has to work independently to ultimately reach the goals of the organization. These dotted lines explain the relationship of the different line authorities with each other, and in this way, functional organization helps in smooth working of the organizational activities to be performed and completed in a. For more clarity of given link, do refer the given